The Mahabharata, Adi Parva, Chapter 9 and Chapter 10. Chapter 9, Pandu cursed. Bhishma was not only a great warrior, but was also a shrewd veteran of the statecraft. It was he who was the architect of the marriage alliance of Gandhari and Dhritarashtra, by which the two countries, the Kuru kingdom and its northwest neighbor, were brought together. Madra was also an important kingdom on the northern frontiers of the Kuru region. At the instance of Bhishma, Pandu married Madri, the princess from the Madra kingdom. Salya, the prince of Madra, was a rising star amongst the versatile warriors of the times. Madri was an exceptionally beautiful and accomplished bride, and Pandu developed a very great attachment for her. One day, Pandu went into the forest on a hunting excursion. Unfortunately, a sage and his wife were enjoying romance in the guise of deer. The male deer was hit by an arrow released by Pandu, and the dying sage cursed Pandu. "Indiscriminate hunter, you have committed the worst sin in shooting a mating couple. You will meet with instantaneous death if you mate with your wife." Pandu was perturbed mentally, as he must deny himself the pleasure of conjugal bed on the pain of death. He retreated to the forest with his two wives on the ostensible pretext of overbearing love for hunting, entrusting the government of the kingdom to Bhishma and Vidura. It was more or less a de facto abdication, and Pandu was not bothered about it as he had no children at the time. In the forest, Pandu was leading a life of asceticism along with his two wives. It was an incongruous situation. Pandu, quite hale and healthy, having two devoted, accomplished young wives, was compelled to kill his legitimate desires owing to a tragic conspiracy of circumstances. End of chapter 9. Beginning of chapter 10. Birth of Pandavas. One day, Pandu exclaimed to Kunti, "How I wish you beget children. I feel criminally guilty whenever I see you. I have denied you the privilege of womanhood." Kunti confided to the tormented king that she was blessed with a boon to invoke any god of her choice by the grace of Durvasa. Pandu insisted that Kunti should use the divine spell to beget children. Kunti, with the avowed intention of pleasing her husband, invoked the god of righteousness, Yama, and Yudhishthira was thus born. Pandu, overjoyed at the birth of a son, encouraged his wife to try again. This time, she invoked the god of wind, and Bhima, of superlative strength, was born. The baby was so strong that the stone on which she was inadvertently dropped by the mother broke into pieces. Pandu, immensely pleasured, asked Kunti to try the spell once again. Kunti invoked Indra, the Lord of Heaven, and Arjuna was born, embodying in himself the prowess of immortal heroism. Pandu was then the proud father of three extraordinary children. Still not satisfied, he asked Kunti to use her spell once more. Kunti very judiciously suggested that propriety required that she should pass on the divine spell to Madri. Pandu then called his beloved wife Madri and asked her to get initiation of the divine mantra from Kunti. Madri, who was given the mantra by Kunti, invoked the twin gods. The divine gods, the Ashwins.